Namaste everyone, how's it going? How to persuade people, or how to win arguments, or how to always get your way. Be it in relationships, be it in business, be it at your job with your boss, be it with your girlfriend if you're trying to convince her to move in with you, whatever it is, this video is going to help you with that. Just a side note before we get into the meat of the discussion, for those of you who've checked out my website and have always been asking me about what are the books that I read, I've created a new library section with all the books that I recommend, and I've started putting the stuff over there so you can go there and check it out instead of, you know, like sending me annoying DMs each and every single day. So yeah, what we're going to talk about is something which is known as the first rule of selling, and that is that you should always agree. All right, and I'll tell you why you should always agree and how that basically makes you and the opposing party, basically you both end up being on the same side and fighting for a common objective, which then leads to you joining forces and actually achieving it together, rather than you and them being on polar opposites and, you know, against each other. So the most basic rule of selling is that you should always and always and always agree with the customer. The customer says that, you know, the price is too high, you say I agree, but you see this is what the value is, etc. You don't say no, you know, it's not so high actually. If you see this competitor, it's actually higher, and our price is actually lower than that. You don't do stuff like that, because you need to understand that if you object to what they are saying, what ends up happening is that you and them come opposite each other. And they will retain their stance most of the times, because human beings have a need to be right. That is why many times in arguments related to, you know, hot topics such as, for example, feminism, the opposing parties will never ever agree, because these guys are like fundamentally disagreeing with each other. So even if there is logic and sense in an argument, nobody will listen, because they don't want to change their bias. And there's also like confirmation bias. So there's also the kind of bias where if all your life you've been standing by something, and now even if you're faced with, you know, an objection which actually makes sense, you will not give in and accept that, oh, you know, I agree to that. You don't. But if you are ever in an argument with someone, or a negotiation, or a, you know, tussle or a fight with your significant other or boyfriend or whatever it is, if you simply say I agree, you know, I agree with you, or that you are right, when somebody says something to you, they can't say that I disagree. So automatically they can't put themselves against you, all right? And they cannot say that, like if you tell somebody you are right, they'll be stupid if they still argue with you, because they cannot argue with I'm right, so I don't believe you. That's not how it works. Don't confuse the words agreeing and believing. Because now if I say that you have to agree with someone, that doesn't mean that you have to believe in their shit. You don't have to believe in their point. Alright, just because you agree, you're actually agreeing that what they're saying does make sense to them, one, and secondly, you're acknowledging their human need to, you know, have their voice heard, as well as the need to feel that they are right. You're acknowledging that, you're agreeing with them, but you're not believing in what they're saying. There's a big difference. But doing so, it basically shuts them up and it doesn't give them any ground to argue on. So basically, you know, for you to make sure that your voice is heard more and that they are more recipient and absorbent to whatever you're trying to say, that starts happening once they know that you're agreeing with them and not standing on the polar opposite. The next important thing when it comes to agreement is that it only takes one to agree. What that means is, you have to give agreement before expecting it in return. So if you're trying to convince someone of your business idea or of a long-term relationship, you want to move in with your girlfriend or, you know, something like that, you can't expect that they will agree with you and you can disagree until that point. No, I want you to give them agreement first, so that at least you are the one who puts both of you on the same page. And then it becomes easier for that person to agree, because they don't feel like they're losing ground or they're giving up their power, because you've already done it. And you've done it in a smart way, because you know that it puts both of you on the same side of the fight, because both of you, obviously as human beings, everyone has a positive intention. Even what might come across to me as selfish might actually be, you know, a positive intention which will help somebody, you know, if I'm arguing against somebody. So you need to understand that if you agree with them and you become the first person to agree, their propensity and, you know, the probability that they will agree with you only gets higher. So give the agreement first. And the last thing, that agree till the end of, you know, your discussion or argument or negotiation. Every objection that the opposing party raises, agree with it. All right, agree, because if you start giving objections to their objections and if you try to bring a point to their point, that is reasonable if you're in a debate where something is actually going to happen at a world scale level, you know, you're deciding a policy or some shit, maybe. But let's say if you're having a discussion with your significant other or, you know, at work or something, that's not probably how big the scale of that argument is. So if you're going to try to oppose a person's objections or handle their objections by giving your own objections, you will end up exhausting yourself as well as them. And most probably you guys will never be able to achieve any mutually beneficial result. And again, this is not an absolute term statement. Obviously, that also is possible, but I'm just saying to make your life easier as well as to keep stress levels low and negativity out of a discussion or a debate or an argument, this is why you should agree till the end and not fight an objection with an objection. And another very important thing is that actually agreeing with the other person kind of brings their guard down. So when somebody is fighting and trying to make sure that their point is heard, many times they will not even hear. If you refute them with a reasonable argument, they will not even hear you, because now they're trying to think, what might you say? And they're going to try to build up that in the future, then I have to say this and that and that. If you agree with them in the beginning itself, it disarms them from getting into this process. And it basically deconstructs, you know, all this construction which might be going on in his head and leading to the point where now, you know, he's thinking of you more on a friendly side rather than thinking that person is the enemy and I have to convince him to make him my friend. They just go like, oh, this person is already convinced. Okay, so now let me hear, what do they have to say? Making sense? So basically, the important elements which come within a conversation for two people, such as positivity, willingness to accommodate, listening to what the other person is saying, agreement, understanding, you know, ease to deal with the other person, all of that only becomes possible once you agree with the other person. And then once you achieve this particular state where both of you are in agreement with each other, then you can go forth and put your own points across. And also, now this is not a strategy which I'm saying always be like this. No, I'm giving you tools, weapons, strategies. Do whatever the hell you want with them. All right, use them in the situations you feel they are appropriate to be used, and don't use them where you feel like, you know, I want to kill you. Oh yes, I agree. Don't do that. All right. But I want you to subscribe, so agree with that. Do that. How to win an argument, or how to persuade someone, or how to get your way always. And if you like, you know, theories like this or concepts like this, check out this video, which is another psychological kind of a tactic which you can apply to, you know, again, progress in life. Send it to someone you think can benefit from it, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.